And so the things I learned from that is really simple. Number one, you have to really understand who your core customer is, and you have to understand how you serve that customer. Number two, you have to ensure that you are delivering on the needs of the customer and understanding the changing dynamics of retail. Meaning, as retail shifts from brick and mortar to e-commerce, you have to have strategies in place to make sure you can serve customers in the way that they desire to be served. And also, I just learned the importance of the CEO talking directly to the frontline employees. Mm-hmm. Because what I found out quickly is that although the company was in a pretty difficult financial situation, you had a lot of employees that had no idea the company was losing money.
Yeah, I bet, and which gets to the point where you've been a little, and frustrated is my word, but you've been trying to figure out how your vision can become at least understood by the broader 300,000+.
Absolutely.
Before we get to that, though, so you made a decision. Lowe's made an announcement recently. 2,000 plus or minus folks in an IT center in Charlotte in a 20-plus story building.
Yeah.
How do you do that fiscally that's responsible for the company? Do you fund that through debt? Do you try to use some cash on hand? And then is that expected, Marvin, to do what you just talked about, and that is to build the top line, or is this some type of infrastructure build-out?
Yeah, great question. It's a combination of both. So let me answer your question on how do we do it fiscally. So we made a commitment back last year that we were going to spend approximately $500 million in technology investment for the next 5 years. That's our commitment to get caught up. Part of that $500 million investment is this IT kind of global technology center that we're going to be putting on the south end of Charlotte.
Yeah.
We believe that in order for us to attract the best and brightest and to be able to start to build the right infrastructure and the right team for technology, we had to put our global location in a place that we would attract, you know, world-class talent. Mm-hmm. You know, as proud as we are about our campus in Morrisville, when you think about the millennial type of prospective employee that we're going to be trying to attract from around the world that wants to be a part of our team, what we've learned, you know, quite specifically is that they're looking for an office location that's close, you know, to an urban center,
mm-hmm.
where they can walk to work, they can catch a light rail, they have access to restaurants, shops, you know, condos, you know, rental houses, apartments, so all of those things. And the South End gives us all of those things. And so this is an investment in the future. You know, what's interesting, we put up a microsite the moment we made the announcement at the end of June. Within the first 24 hours, we had over 700 people from around the world to ping us on that site, requesting additional information so that they can look at it as a prospective, you know, employment situation. And so we're really pleased with the early response. We're pleased with the partnership from the city, the state, and the county to allow us to make this happen. And looking candidly, we had a pretty broad search. We looked at a lot of major cities in North America, and we had a lot of cities vying mm-hmm. for us to put this location there, but we felt strongly that Charlotte gave us exactly what we needed, and we're pleased mm-hmm. to be able to stay close to our hometown.